Nilay's chemistry.
Let's start off with a problem. A person drops a pound of bricks and a pound of feathers down from their window. Which has more matter, the bricks or the feathers? Now, you might be tempted to say feathers, but let's recall what matter is. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Mass defines the quantity of matter in an object. Mass tells us when we have a lot of matter, like an elephant, or only a little bit of matter, like a mouse. So back to the problem. Which has more matter, a pound of bricks or a pound of feathers? Well, they both have a mass of 1 pound, so they have the same amount of matter. Now, even though bricks and feathers are very different, they're both made up of matter. But what exactly is matter made up of? Matter is made up of one or many microscopic building blocks called atoms. An atom is the smallest unit of matter, and they are so tiny that a penny contains approximately 2.3 times 10 to the 22nd atoms, or 23 sextillion atoms. However, all of the sextillions of atoms in a penny aren't the same. A penny is made up of copper and zinc atoms. Copper and zinc are just two examples of the 118 different elements that exist. An element is a substance that cannot be decomposed into a simpler substance by chemical means. Essentially, if you have an element, no reaction with heat or another chemical can break it down into a simpler substance. Hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, gold, and arsenic are all different elements. When you have a sample of an element, it can consist of one or more atoms. So elemental neon exists as a singular free atom which does not interact with any other atoms. Elemental gold usually exists as millions or trillions of connected atoms, while oxygen exists in a diatomic molecular form with two oxygen atoms. Oxygen, in its elemental form, is an example of a molecule because its two atoms are chemically bound together. A molecule is the smallest physical unit of an element or compound, and it is anything made up of two or more atoms held together by a chemical bond. So if atoms are held together by bonds, then it also makes sense that these bonds can be broken and allow different atoms to then bond together, almost like Lego blocks. For example, water, or H2O, comprises two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. In this chemical reaction, hydrogen, or H2, and oxygen, or O2, react to form water. The chemical bonds holding the diatomic oxygen molecules together are broken so that each oxygen atom can then bond with two hydrogen atoms. By rearranging the way that atoms are attached to one another, reactions like this can occur where one molecule is transformed into another. A good analogy is that atoms are like letters and molecules are like words. If we change the order or type of letter, we make different words with different meanings. If we change the order or type of atom, we make different molecules with different properties. So let's summarize what we have learned. Matter is made up of atoms, and we can obtain different types of matter from objects being built with different elements. So, while a pound of bricks and a pound of feathers have the same amount of matter, they're made of different elemental building blocks called atoms that then give them different properties. This is why a pound of bricks dropping down from above is a lot scarier than a pound of feathers.
Nilay's chemistry, they did.